إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره، نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، فإن كل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار، وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. Greet you all with the greeting of Islam. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. May the peace and the blessing of Almighty Allah be with you all. I'd like to welcome you all for continuation of our series 100 Advices by the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم compiled by Muhammad Al-Sa'dli. And this morning, inshallah, we're working in segment number 45, page number 23, or advice number 45. عن ابن عباس رضي الله عنه قال سمعت عمر بن الخطاب يقول على المنبر سمعت عمر رضي الله عنه يقول سمعت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم على المنبر يقول لا تطروني كما أطرت النصارى ابن مريم، فإنما أنا عبده، فقولوا عبد الله ورسوله. Narrated Umar, may Allah be pleased with him, I heard the Prophet of Allah saying, do not exaggerate in my praising me as the Christians praise the Son of Mary, for I am only a slave, so call me the slave of Allah and His Messenger. This narration, which is from Ibn Abbas, may Allah be pleased with him, that Umar radiallahu anhu is saying, I heard the Prophet of Allah from the pulpit, i.e. the member, is saying, don't praise me more than what Allah had given me. Don't imitate the Christian when they praise Jesus, Son of Mary, so much. Because I am a slave servant of Allah. So say about me what Allah said, which is His slave and His messenger. This advice from the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to us as Muslims in his time and after his death, that he wants us to be on a track, on the proper track, on the Sirat al-Mustaqim. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he caring for us. He's concerned for our future especially in the hereafter. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam want us to learn from the previous nations how they went into kufr and disbelief and shirk. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam inviting us and advising us not to exaggerate concerning his personality. And he's reminding us about what had happened in the nations before us. And he gave example with the Christian when they elevated Jesus, son of Mary, more than what he is, to such a degree he made him equal to Allah, while others they said that he is son of Allah, while others they said that he is three parts and he is one of these parts. With this confusion, why? Because they put their senses on the aqidah. They put their logic, their feeling, the fake love to be authority. While the authority in Islam and in any revealed books before, that you go according your master, which Allah, your creator. Do not deviate, do not invent, follow. This is the job of the Muslims at any time, in any place. Not to invent, but to follow. When the Muslims start to invent in their deen, and the relationship between them and Allah, and the relationship with others, this is the destruction. We have to learn from the previous nations why they went astray. Exaggeration. Nowadays we hear and we see that some Muslims exaggerate the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, or they praising his son-in-law and his cousin Ali, may Allah be pleased with him, beyond his position. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam advising us to follow as-sirat al-mustaqim, especially in matter of aqidah and belief. Don't exaggerate, don't praise me so much, more than what Allah gave me. See what happened to the nations before you. They spoke so much about Isa alayhi salam, son of Mary, until they became, put him to be equal to Allah, or even more greater than Allah, or that he is the Godhead. And he said, whenever you talk about me, don't exaggerate. Believe in what Allah gave me is the position of wasila in the akhirah, intercession by the will of Allah, or that the judgment is not going to start before him, or that his nation will be the first to enter Jannah. Anything that Allah told us about the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in Quran or in the authentic hadith, we say ala al-ayn wal-ra's, we respect it and we follow it, but we don't make our logic and common sense. Some people, they said Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is nur arshillah, is the light of the throne of Almighty Allah. Where is this in Islam? Where is this in Quran? Where is this in Hadith? Who told you that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the light of the throne of Almighty Allah? While others they say, if it's not Muhammad, Allah did not create anything else. Only Allah created everything because the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is not true. Allah is saying the opposite of this. Allah is saying in Quran, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. Indeed, I had created jinn and mankind for purpose of worshiping me, serving me, obeying me. So we are not supposed to invent anything related to this deen. Follow, don't invent. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam showing us the way to be saved, that we follow and not to invent. Say about me what Allah said about me. Believe in me in the way that Allah wants you to believe in me. What it is? Abdullahi wa Rasulu. Messenger of Allah, Rasulullah, and the slave servant of Allah. He's the messenger of Allah, but he have to pray, he have to fast. He have to do everything that Allah order and command. So he is a slave servant of Allah. And this is an honor. This is an honor. This is not degrading the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam or taking away from his position. There is nothing better than a person, he or she, to be a slave servant of Allah. So let's follow the direction and the way of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, concerning him, concerning the Sahaba, concerning any matter of belief, especially about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. What? He say, indeed I am his slave. So he say, the slave of Almighty Allah and his messenger. May the peace and the blessing of Allah be upon our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. May Allah give us the means and the ability that we follow, not to invent. Subhanak Allahumma bihamdik, ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant, nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. We advise our brothers and sisters to get this booklet, 100 Advices by the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, compiled by Muhammad S. Adley. And for those whom Allah blessed them with wealth, they should buy 100 and distribute it to their masajid, to their friends. People buying different kind of gifts to gift to the people. If you go to Starbucks, you will spend more money on a cup of coffee than buying this booklet. It's authentic information. And we need to promote anything related to Allah and His Messenger. Let's spend in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Jazakum Allah khairan.
Yes,
the numbers are in Arabic as well as in that book, like the page, I mean not the page, but I know the pages in.
There is pages, but there is no numbers for the hadith.
Yeah, that's what I was saying.
So this was part of my shortcoming or my mistakes.
But I noticed today you said
so page now 28.
Huh? I noticed this morning you said page 28.
Yes.
Okay.
Is that,
okay.
No, I said 23.
23? Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
But inshallah, when we revise the book again, okay, we put numbers and I will double check things to understand more thoroughly. But
yeah, I was looking, I said, well, you said, I mean,